Hiya, you all right?
Can I ask why you're taking photographs of North Wales Police property?
Well, actually, it belongs to the public, and yeah, you can ask, but I don't have to answer.
What's your name, sir?
I am okay.
Yeah. What's your name?
What's the emergency? Somebody with a camera?
Well, take a picture of police premises.
Public premises. Are we done?
It's a threat to security, sir.
Oh my God, no. Really, a camera?
Yes, it is.
That's funny, because all the documents produced by the police suggest it isn't, but fill me in if you want to.
Why are you taking photographs of our...
Because I want to. Because it is my right to do so, and I want to. And that's what I'm going to do.
And what do you intend to do with the images?
Doesn't matter. None of your business.
It's my business that you're taking photographs of a secure unit.
Okay. All right, am I detained?
Not at this time.
See you later.
Changing.
Yeah. No, thank you. I'm beyond help.
You're beyond help?
Yeah. Can I help you?
Yeah, I work here, I'm a police officer.
How does that mean you want to help?
Well, you're photographing a public building, aren't you, in the police building? So
that's right, yeah.
Security risks to the police, so that's why I'm stopped.
Oh, right.
To speak to you.
Okay, yeah. So how can I help you?
Well, so what are you photographing the building for then? What's your intention?
Well, I don't have to tell you that, but it's lawful. So that's why I'm doing it.
So you're just here to take photographs of a police building. Do you not think that's a security risk to us?
Is it lawful?
Well, that's not. I asked you the question first, then.
I don't think it is, but how long have you been having this paranoia?
I'm not paranoid, but I work in a job to do with the public where terrorism is a real risk. You're walking around the police premises
really?
With a woolly hat on, dark glasses, recording things and taking videos of private vehicles and people coming and going from their workplace.
Well, it's been sunny today, and I always wear a woolly hat. I didn't realise the woolly hat was connected to terrorism or a camera.
Are you trying to conceal your identity, maybe?
I'm trying to keep my head warm.
All right, okay, so the sunglasses as well.
Well, when I was downtown a minute ago, that was tracking the flags. But is there anything against the law wearing sunglasses?
I didn't say there was that. Just that's how it appears. Can you not see how I would perceive that?
And I'm well, going to my I can
own
see, but
car now, my own private vehicle. And should I really be photographed? The same as how would you feel if I turned up and photographed you outside your house?
Oh, well, this isn't your house, so that analogy.
No, but I'm going to get in my private car now.
That analogy is wrong.
So you've no right to take photographs of me.
The fact that I'm out in my car every day and getting photographed, usually by the police, and it all goes on your computer. I don't have a computer to be abused like you do, but what's the problem with you getting on your car?
Right, okay, well, if you can't, do you not think this is suspicious behaviour, this?
I don't think, well, it doesn't matter to me because suspicion, what does that mean? If you're relying on suspicion, which is the lowest of all
how do I
all
not
techniques.
Know that you're recording video, taking photographs of here because you pose a security risk to us?
Well, you're saying that as if you have a right to know. And that's entitlement, isn't it?
I've got a right to ask you your details then, haven't I?
You have got a right, and I've got a right to refuse them.
Okay. So maybe you should perhaps think about going.
I have thought about it, and I'm staying.
Right, okay. You can do exactly what you want.
Which one's your car?
I'm going nowhere near my car at the moment, am I?
Come on, I'll walk you to it.
No, you won't, because you'll take a photograph of me getting into my car, and I'm not doing that.
You are switched, aren't you, Sherlock? Okay.
You're completely out of order, mate.
No, I'm not.
If you've got an issue with the police,
I have got an issue with the police. I've got an issue with my rights. I like to have, my rights protected. What is your right? What's your right that I'm actually impinging at the moment?
Right, it's all about my human rights to a private life. What about that now? So I'm going from my workplace. That's my workplace.
Yeah.
You take a picture of that. I haven't got a problem with that. This is a private vehicle car park.
Okay.
It's not
just keep your distance from me.
So if I go over there and get in my car, sorry. And I drive off and you took a photograph of me in my car, that's not right, is it? Because you're breaching my right to a private life.
Right.
Yeah?
You don't really know about your Article 8 of the human rights then, if that's what you think right to privacy is. Because you don't have a right to privacy out in public. And this area is classed as public by the police's own definition.
Arguable point. We could argue that.
Let me finish. You're actually arguing against the police if you dispute that, not just against me. So, do you want to do that?
So why have you got the right to do all that?
I imagine it goes back to Magna Carta, and then up through the years, we've built on our rights. But I do have the right to do this. I'm not breaking any law. I'm allowed to photograph what I want from a public area. And this is deemed as a public area.
So what if I started photographing you now, then?
That's great. That's fine.
Right.
Do you want to practice?
I'm not handling your camera, because you'll probably say I've broken it and try and send us a bill for it.
I think you have, actually. I think it's broken, though. I think taking a picture of you has broken it. Yeah, help yourself. How's that?
Fine.
Are you not going home now? Okay, well, I'm going to be here 10 minutes, so I don't want to stop you from going home. There we go again. What do you think I'm doing? Photographing? Just keep your distance from me, please.
Can you're taking photographs of these premises.
Yeah.
Why is it that you're doing that then?
Well, I don't have to tell you that. All you need to...
Okay,
can you let me finish, please? Let me finish. I don't have to tell you that because it's lawful to take a picture of anything from a public place.
Right, but under the Counter-Terrorism Act,
okay,
taking pictures of police premises and police buildings is unlawful, isn't it?
No, it's not. What are you talking about? Section 43?
So at the moment...
Just answer my question. Are you on about Section 43?
Buildings are, what aren't you
what section are you on about?
He's just taking photographs of all of us and also recording. Just wait there a minute.
Yeah.
Gentleman's taking photographs of us at the moment and he is recording.
Yeah.
And I am really concerned because obviously it's the police premises that he's recording. Well, you answered the job from response, have you?
We have, yeah.
Brilliant. Can I leave it with you because I've got to get back to write something else from child protection? I think perhaps it might be prudent to get a supervisor down here as well.
Yeah. Not you anyway, because you don't know the law, do you?
Pardon?
Not you anyway, because you don't know the law.
In terms of the law and the Counter-Terrorism Act, I'm not 100% in favour that I'm going to go and look back up the building now.
Well, listen, we'll hang on here for you. You go and have a look, all right?
However, you can't be coming around taking
photographs. You know what? You can. You can. You go and look the law up. We'll hang on here for you.
I need to leave it with these two colleagues still because I'm in the middle of dealing with something else, unfortunately.
Okay.
Yeah, no worries.
How's it going?
Bad,
slow day, guys.
What's up?
Slow day.
No, I just had reports.
Okay, have you?
Obviously,
right.
Yourself taking photographs. Yeah. Videos.
Oh my God, yeah.
Yeah.
Have you ever had a big job like this before? Somebody taking photographs.
So, what brings you over here anyway?
A car.
Okay, are you from around here?
That's nothing to do with you, is it?
Well, it is a little bit, isn't it?
No, it's not.
If you've travelled
not
from,
at all.
If you've travelled from England, then you're in breach of coronavirus legislation. Aren't
so
you?
Have you got any details to suggest that?
Not in the moment, no.
Okay. However. Do you think you're going to have within 5 minutes or so?
Why, do you intend to leave now?
Well, I don't know. I'm quite spontaneous, so... You all right, mate? You're looking confused there.
Okay. You all right?
Yeah, good. Right, am I detained?
No, you're not.
See you later, guys. Have a great day. All right. Oh, hold on, somebody coming out.
Why are you photographing people's vehicles while they're leaving?
Because it's within my rights to do so. And impeding it is actually an offence.
It's not, though, is it?
It is.
It's not.
It is.
It's an offence to impede someone taking a photograph.
It is.
No, it's not.
It's because it's inhibiting my a lawful activity.
OK. You got your work scope, then, you know?
Yeah.
1377 to 3167. Could you email those details that you sent over to 3615, please? 3615 3615. What is it you're taking photographs of us exactly?
Anything that I want to from a public space.
Okay, but why specifically?
Well, it doesn't matter why. It never matters why. It's just can I.
Well, it does kind of matter.
No, it doesn't matter. It's can I. Because if I can, and this is lawful, you don't have any more questions for me, do you?
I clearly do have questions now.
Well, why would you?
Because you're taking photographs and videos of police personnel and of police premises. Now, the question then has to be asked, you know, why are you photographing the personal vehicles of police personnel?
Doesn't matter if it's lawful.
Question. Well, not necessarily.
Doesn't matter. Well, you've had enough documents from the police put out to you to explain that. If you haven't read them, that's your problem.
And
go and look them up. Go and look them up because it's gone to all forces.
How would you be aware of that exactly?
Aren't you supposed to do something now you switch that on?
I can inform you that my body-worn camera is recording, as is
okay.
Your GoPro and the remainder of your videoing equipment.
Yeah, but I don't have UK Home Office guidance to tell me when I'm actually videoing you. You do, don't you? But I've just had to tell you to do that, haven't I?
You told me within about 3 seconds of it being on, and if I may point out, it was very much obvious with the bleep.
Just stay there, please.
Wasn't it? Yeah? I think we can both agree that it was...
I don't know, I think you did it a little bit shiftily there.
Well, it's not very stealthy, is it, when it bleeps and flashes? And
well, how do you know I might have bad hearing? How do you know I've got bad hearing or not?
Well,
but you deal with people with impaired hearing.
Points at the moment, aren't we? Now, the main issue is you being here photographing police premises.
Well, that's your main issue, it's nobody else's,
well,
is it?
For a reason. You know, why are you doing this?
Because I want to.
Why?
Because I want to.
And what are you doing with the photographs and the video?
Whatever I want to.
Has that email come through?
Yeah. How are we doing with that email? Oh, this is great. Oh my God, what's that, pool cat? Can we send you any of these?
No, thanks.
See you later.
Thank you.
Oh, not my case. Getting on, guys.
Good, thank you. How are you?
No arrest you then?
Pardon?
Any detainments or arrest you?
No, you carry on.
Oh, fantastic. Oh, not good parking that, mate, is it?
I know.
Jesus. These police officers and possibly headquarters are so bothered about a guy with a camera that they have three police vehicles or police cars, and at one point a cop bike joined them, and they were going up and down all the roads to all the industrial units. I was always in sight of one vehicle. As one vehicle left or passed, another one would arrive. They'd go up the road, turn round the roundabout, come back, go round that roundabout, come back, go up the road I was on, turn round and come back, and so on and so forth. So what they were trying to do was find my vehicle and keep their eye on me. And it was quite hard to lose them because I was always in sight of a police car. But at one point, I realised that the guy was going to have to drive all the way down to the roundabout and turn around. And at that point, I went up, I went through some woodland and I hid behind a hedge. And I just stayed there for about 20 minutes, 25 minutes. And I could see the police cars coming back and to along the hedge line, but they couldn't see me. And then as soon as I thought it was safe, I made my way back to my car. And then I went south rather than north, because I'm sure they were expecting me to get on the expressway that was heading towards England. And I don't know what they're going to try and do me for. Possibly could have found anything, or it might have been COVID related, even though I was there lawfully on the day because I was actually working within Wales that day. Just... Here's another police car on me here. So just for taking photographs, we've got one up there, and then we've got one here. And they're taking off now. Where are they going?